Welcome to a course on Test Your C Programming Skills, a guide to crack IT interview. We are discussing second topic in this course, that is storage classes and functions, and this is second session in this topic. Let's get started with some key points. Static storage class. A static variable is initialized only when corresponding function executes first time. This is different than initialization of local variable, which happens every time the particular function is called. Static variable retains value across the function calls, and scope of static variable is limited to a function in which it is declared, whereas the lifetime is equal to lifetime of the program. Default value for static variable is 0. Few other important points regarding the storage classes and functions are as here. Please note that program execution always starts from main function. So main is said to be an entry point of the program. Default return type of function in C language is integer. So if you do not mention any return type for a function, then by default it is assumed to be integer. Please note that return statement can return maximum one value at a time. Regarding the function arguments, there are two terminologies. First one is actual argument and the second one is a formal argument. Actual argument are the arguments used while calling a function, whereas the formal argument is the arguments received by the function. Let's discuss first program of this session. Please see the code carefully and guess the output. In the program, there is a recursive function, recfun, which is called from the main function. In the recfun function, there is an integer variable p declared and initialized to 5. And there is an if condition. If it is a true, then it is printing the value of p, then decrementing the value of p, and finally again making a recursive call. A recursive function is a function which calls itself. So on line number 10, rec function is calling itself, and that's why it is a recursive function. So what is the answer of this program? And the correct answer is, this program prints number 5 infinitely. Let's understand why we are getting this output. Please note that variable p declared in the rec function is a local variable and it is initialized to 5 every time rec function is called. So if condition in the rec function is always true and this program continuously prints the value 5 and it happens infinitely. Let's move to the next example. Please see this code. Now it is similar to the previous one with only one difference on line number 5. Now here p is not a local variable, but it is a static variable. The rest of the code is similar to the previous example. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, this program outputs numbers 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's understand why we are getting this output. Please note that here p is a static variable. It is initialized to 5 when a rec function is called first time. And at that time, due to p minus minus, the value of p is decremented to 4. And this value is retained when rec function is called again. So next time, it displays the value 4 and this continues till the value of p is greater than or equal to 0, and that time this recursive function stops. This program prints the value of p initially, that is at the line number 8, and later on making the call to recursive function. So the output is 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's move to the next example. Please see the code given on the slide carefully and guess the output. In the code, there is a call to printc function from the main function twice. In the printc function, there is a static variable of the type character. The variable c is incremented by 1 and it is returning the value of c. So what will be the output of this program? And the correct answer is, output will be b and c. Let's understand why we are getting this output. Please note that here c is a static variable in printc function. It is initialized to character a when the function is called first time. Hence, printc function, when it executes first time, it initializes the value of c to character a, and then after executing c++, the value stored in character c is b. Now next time when this printc function is called, then due to c++, the value stored in character variable c is incremented to make it small c, which is return, and that's why second time it prints the character small c. Let's move to the next example. Please see this code carefully and guess the output. From the main function, there is a call to function 1. In function 1, it is printing a message welcome 1. And there is one more function, function 2, which is defined in function 1. And there is a call to function 2 function at line number 10. So what will be the output of this code? And the correct answer is, the output is welcome 1 space welcome 2. Let's understand why we are getting this output. Please note that here in this program, one function is defined in another function, that is function 2 is defined in function 1. Please note that declaring one function inside other function is accepted by GCC compiler. Please note that declaring one function inside other function is accepted by the compiler GCC, but it is not acceptable by Turbo C compiler. So this type of code is not accepted by Turbo C and it will give a compiler error. When function 1 is called, it first displays the message welcome 1, and then it makes calls to the function 2, which in turn display the message welcome 2. Let's move to the next example. Please see this code carefully and guess the output. This code is similar to the previous example with one difference. Here, call to function 2 is there on the line number 14, which was in previous case, it was in the function 1 itself. So what will be the output of this code? And the correct answer is, this program gives the compiler error. Let's understand why we are getting compiler error for this program. As discussed last time, declaring one function inside other function is acceptable to GCC, but it is not acceptable to Turbo C. Here, function 2 is defined inside function 1. Hence, it is known only in the scope of function 1. So when function 2 call is made from the main function, then it raises a compiler error. So coming next is third part of the topic, storage classes and functions. Till then, enjoy C programming.